The Milwaukee Journal Sentinel's Preps Plus is brought to you by Boston Store. Your store, your style. By the Fradert and the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network, where sports medicine experts help athletes maximize their potential.
Welcome again to Preps Plus. We're coming to you this week from Riverside High School in Milwaukee. Hi, I'm Mark Stewart, prep editor of the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel. And this man right here is the grand exalted, the grand poo by the king, Lance Allen from today's TMJ4.
Mark must want something out of me this week. But on the show, we will see the Riverside boys basketball team try to earn at least a share of the city conference championship. And we'll have girls basketball regional finals action as well. We'll start tonight on the court right here at Riverside, where we'll meet one of the area's top players.
He'll be playing Division I ball next year, but this year he hopes to finish his senior season in Madison. Here's Brad Preter with the Boston Store featured student athlete.
He's got an intensity level that matches his love for the game. 6'6 Terrence Lewis says his desire to be great goes back a long time.
Since I was little, I mean, I always had a ball in my hand, and I knew right there that ball was going to be my life. So that's what makes me just work hard every day, get better every day, challenge myself, like with dribble skills, shots, step back, side steps.
Last year's Journal Sentinel Area Player of the Year, Lewis has put together another outstanding season. The Iowa State recruit is averaging better than 26 points per game, while also pushing his teammates to get better.
He's a leader, he helps us on the court, he talks to us, makes sure we're doing what we need to do, make sure we're on task 24/7.
We all look up to him as a player, so he really leads us on the court. He has an impact more than just his athletic ability, I guess. He really leads us on the court.
Terrence has played his entire high school career with his dad, Rock Lewis, as his head coach.
He pushes the kids as much as he can. You know, sometimes, you know, he pushes them a little harder than he's supposed to, and the response some of the kids got, but he's trying his best to be a leader, because, you know, where he's going next year, that someone had to push him and, you know, and show him how the game is going to be played.
Terrence chose Iowa State over several other major programs. He says the recruiting process was something of an adventure.
It was kind of weird with the reporters, the college coaches, the write-ups, all that, but in the end run, I started maturing more, got better at it, took some of the advice from the college coaches. So, I mean, it was kind of weird, but at the same time, it just gave me a lot of strong advice for myself in the upcoming world.
That recruiting for him, was tough. It was, got to the point that he like, I can't take it no more, you know. But we sat down, we talked about it, and I think we made a good decision.
Coach Lewis feels it took the Tigers quite a while to find their identity this season after losing some major players to transfer and graduation.
Just working hard every day in practice, staying focused, being on each other, tails here and there and stuff like that.
Terrence calls the team a great bunch of guys who have really bonded. Now the Tigers are focusing on getting farther than last year when they lost a heartbreaker in their sectional final.
State, that's all we want. That's all we're striving for. That's all we're working for. State. We lost by 1 point against Marquette. It was a good team, good game, good crowd. I mean, but we just came up short, so we just got to learn from our mistakes and just see if we can do this year.
While anything less than a trip to Madison would be a disappointment, the Lewises will someday be able to look back on an impressive run together at Riverside.
In the classroom, we do the action job, you know, get the assignment done and practice early in the morning and practice late at night sometime or go to work out. But, you know, he accomplished a lot, and I'm really proud of him as a father, also as a coach.
The Tigers are a number 4 seed in their sectional. They open up tournament play Friday when they play host to South Division.
At the end of an early morning practice, Terrence receives his award courtesy of Boston Store.
All right, I'd like to present Terrence Lewis with the featured athlete of the week. Yeah.
Hi, I'm Jack Dougherty of the Milwaukee Admirals. Stay tuned for hockey highlights on Preps Plus.
We get it. You're always on the go. That's why Boston Store is ready anytime you want to shop, day or night, or anytime in between. At bostonstore.com, you'll find more brands, styles, and sizes to get you going, to work or to play. And with web exclusives, free online shipping, and convenient in-store returns, it's never been easier. What are you waiting for? Shop bostonstore.com. Boston Store, your store, your style.
Think of joint pain like a warning light in your car. It means something in your body isn't working right or could be damaged. And the Freidart and the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network is where you go to keep everything in working order. Our orthopedic and spine specialists will show you all your options, from non-surgical remedies like physical therapy to minimally invasive treatments and advanced surgical techniques to get you going again. Isn't it good to know what is possible?
Welcome back to Preps Plus, coming to you this week from Riverside High School in Milwaukee. While the boys' basketball teams were wrapping up their regular season, the girls were already in tournament mode.
We've got action from the WIAA Regional Finals. Here are your Preps Plus highlights.
The Woodland West has been a powerhouse all season, with three teams currently among the state's top seven in Division II. A pair of those met in the regional final tonight as number 3 Pewaukee hosted number 7 New Berlin Eisenhower. The Lions are the defending D2 champs, and they came out on fire. Katie Ludwig splits the defense and gets the deuce. Ike jumps out 7-0. But Jinda Gittinger leads the Pirates on a huge run. This short baseline J ties the game at 10. Then she uses a nice spin move inside for two more. She had 17, Pewaukee up 17-14. Back come the Lions as they close the half strong. Julia Hintz from downtown, she had 4 threes on the night. It's 25 all at the break. Coach Todd Hansen had some magic words for the Pirates at halftime as they explode early in the second. Mackenzie Schill goes coast to coast to put the home team up 7. Later, she loses her balance, but still gets the shot to fall. A 15-2 blitz has Pewaukee up 40-27, and the fans can taste a berth in the sectionals. But the defending champs had other ideas. Jasmine Samar Singh gets the friendly roll on this three as the lead is cut to 6. And when Ludwig finds Hannah Plockelman for the lay-in, this game is all even at 51. Schill calmly drains a pair of free throws to put the Pirates up 2 with under a minute to play. But the Lions' playoff experience really pays off. Hintz finds a wide-open Olivia Kennedy, who nails the clutch 3 to give Ike the lead. Pewaukee with one last gasp, but Riley Solomon's shot is blocked, and the Lions hold on. Eisenhower stays alive for the repeat as they survive Pewaukee 58-53.
Being at state last year really, I think, helped this game, and everyone just stayed confident, had positive energy, and Pewaukee's such a good team, and I'm just so proud of our team.
I'm so happy and pleased because they're the ones that did it tonight. They didn't quit, and they hit the shots when they needed to. So whether it was past experience or anything we did, all I know is we told them to keep the fight and keep the faith, and they did.
Since both their boys and girls teams have been enjoying great seasons, Martin Luther High School has the brackets for both tourneys posted in the gym. The girls took a 22-1 record into their regional final. They'd face a young Kettle Moraine Lutheran squad that brought along a patriotic cheering section. The pick and roll works early on here for Kettle Moraine Lutheran. Amanda Porth to Ariana Miller, bouncing off the contact and scoring. You can't leave Emily Hafeman all alone. She is a deadeye from downtown. Hafeman nailed a couple of threes in the first half. Sophomore Bonnie Jensen will also dial it up long distance. She's on the mark. It's 11-2 Spartans. Timeout KML. Megan Sina will find a gap in the defense and take advantage off the window, but this would be an uphill battle for the Chargers. Martin Luther plays opportunistic defense. Bailey Sasuetka comes up with the steal. She won't be able to finish, but sophomore Emma Callis is right there for the putback and one. That extends the lead. Abigail Washburn and Amanda Porth each scored 10 for KML. There's Porth with a nice move. But here's more Spartan defense. Bailey Sasuetka knocks it free, Emma Callis will take it the distance and convert the three-point play. Martin Luther up big at the half. Second half, they'll move the ball nicely. Grace Amling to Emily Hafman to Callis for two of her game-high 19. Martin Luther was knocked out in the regional finals last year. Wasn't going to happen this time. Nice move by Brooke Blasey. The Spartans win it 58-43 to claim the regional championship.
The feeling's amazing. There's no other feeling, but we're not done. We're not satisfied. There's more to come.
We've been talking about steps all year, and it's just about taking one step at a time. We're not looking any farther than the next game, and that's going to be Brookfield Academy, and that's what we need to prepare for, because if we look anything past that, that's where we get into trouble. So one game at a time, one step at a time, as we try to reach our ultimate goal.
On Friday night, the Milwaukee Vincent boys basketball team had a chance to win the city conference championship outright.
But Riverside needed a win to grab a share of the crown. Is Riverside and Vincent the perfect Preps Plus game of the week?
With all the basketball tradition here at Milwaukee Vincent, it's almost surprising that the Vikings hadn't won a city conference boys championship in 10 years. Well, coming into this regular season finale, Vincent already owned a share of the city title for this year, and a victory over Riverside would give the Vikings the league championship outright.
The Vikings have been making noise in the conference all year and were trying to finish unbeaten in the city. Defending conference champ Riverside had other ideas. Carlos Curtis, sweet move, the start of a big night for him. In this game, you have to be able to deal with rejection. There's a big one by Vincent's Andrew Lewis, but he gets a taste of his own medicine on this end from Alondis Williams. Tigers in transition now. It's Terrence Lewis with a stylish move of his own. Riverside down two. Speaking of nice moves, here's Justin Brookins hanging in midair for the reverse layup. He would lead the Vikings with 17. Now check out the no-look pass from Andrew Lewis to Alfonso Fields underneath. Vincent leads by three at the break. Alondis Williams came up big in the second half for Riverside. Fewer power on his way to the rack, he drops it home. Kente Ruching goes hard to the hole on the far end, and one, he'd convert the three-point play. Here's another nice move by Alondis Williams, slicing between defenders to give Riverside the lead with just over 2 minutes left. Alfonso Fields will fire the inbounds pass deep to Justin Brookins, who corrals it and then finds Isaiah Banks all alone. Vincent back up one. They'd go to overtime, tied at 59. In the OT, Carlos Curtis comes off the pick and buries the three ball to put the Tigers on top. Moments later, this time Curtis won't use the pick. Instead, it's the drive, the jump stop, and two more of his game-high 34. Finally, it's Curtis with a spin move. He'll get rid of it, and the ball ends up in the hands of Alondis Williams. Three-point play. Tigers win 76-65. Riverside shares the city conference title along with Vincent and Washington.
The good thing is, I mean, we're still the champion. We didn't get a chance to win outright, but we didn't make the defensive plays that is needed to become a champion. I mean, that's what it boiled down to.
We just came out with a chip on our shoulder to show everybody that Riverside still got it. We came out to show that our record didn't reflect our team. And we came out and gave our all and got the W.
Riverside and Vincent could potentially have a rematch in the sectional final in a couple of weeks, but Mark, Oak Creek and Brookfield Central definitely want to stand in their way.
That's right, Lance. And for more hoops info like final standings, tournament schedules, and a whole lot more, be sure to check out the Preps Plus website at jsonline.com. And stick around, we're going to meet an up-and-coming MPS boys basketball team.
We're also going to have WIAA sectional final action in hockey, so don't miss that.
We get it. You're always on the go. That's why Boston Store is ready anytime you want to shop, day or night, or anytime in between. At bostonstore.com, you'll find more brands, styles, and sizes to get you going, to work or to play. And with web exclusives, free online shipping, and convenient in-store returns, it's never been easier. What are you waiting for? Shop bostonstore.com. Boston Store, your store, your style.
No matter what your schedule, personality, or lifestyle, Our primary care providers do everything possible to make every day a little healthier. It all begins by listening and getting to know you. It's about convenience with flexible hours and locations near you. And it's about connections linking you to the power of academic medicine right in your community. For a primary care provider who gets you, get to us.
Jack Dougherty played his high school hockey in Minnesota, then spent 1 year skating for the Wisconsin Badgers, and now he's a Milwaukee Admiral.
Dougherty has had some special moments on the ice. Here's Jack Dougherty in this week's edition of From Preps to Pros.
There's nothing like it. You know, you look at the state tournament and they sell out an 18,000 person arena, you know, months beforehand, so there's a lot of hype around it. And I was fortunate enough to play in the state tournament twice, and we won both times, so I'd say those were definitely two of the defining moments of playing hockey for me.
High school hockey in Minnesota is huge, and it was a great experience for Jack Dougherty. But Dougherty was considered something of a late bloomer. When he was chosen to play for Team USA's U-17 squad in the Czech Republic, the choice surprised some people.
Summer going into junior, it all kind of clicked for me and I figured it out. And here's this kid from Minnesota that nobody has heard about that goes into the development camp or whatever they call it in the summer for USA Hockey and is ultimately chosen to go overseas and represent our country. So it was kind of exciting for me and my family to kind of prove people wrong.
Following his junior year, Dougherty went off to join the USA National Team Development Program, which turned out to be a great move.
The team that I was fortunate enough to play on had so many good players that made me better every day, and it all kind of culminated at the end when we went to Finland to play in the U18 World Championships and came away with a gold medal. So that was, you know, 3 years in a row of winning something really big. That was very exciting for me.
The winning ways, unfortunately, did not continue during Dougherty's one season with the Badgers. UW won just 4 games that season, but Dougherty tried to stay upbeat.
We came into the rink every day, and we may not have won every single game, but we stayed positive and we were committed to, you know, the team goals and trying to get better every day.
Following that season, the well-traveled Dougherty was drafted by the Predators, spent a great year with the Portland Winterhawks, and is now in his first full season in Milwaukee, hopefully his final stop before the NHL.
It's just important to come in here every day and work hard and try and get better every single day. And I think the message from our coaching staff and some of the older guys is just to keep it positive. You know, injuries or whatever, you never know what's going to happen and you never know when you're going to get your chance. So stay positive and stay ready.
Last year, the boys basketball team at Milwaukee Golda Meir won 2 games in its first season. This year, the victory total increased exponentially.
Boy, that's one of those high point words in Scrabble, Mark. I'm impressed.
Hey, what do you expect? I went to Miami of Ohio.
That is the Harvard of the Midwest. As Craig Harden explains, though, our team of the week definitely wants to keep building for the future.
Milwaukee Golda Meir is only in its second year of having a boys varsity basketball team. And after coming up 1 game short of winning the school's first ever conference title in only its second year of competing.
You know, I was brought to a school that was like Stanford, a bunch of smart kids. And, you know, in my head, all I had to do was get these kids to learn how to play basketball. So throughout the summer, the guys worked out really hard. Then we got a couple of transfers that came here that made us really stronger. So that made the difference from this year to last year and the commitment of the kids.
From last year, it was rough. Coming to winning 2 games, coming to win multiple games. I mean, the transfer has been good. We've been doing our thing this year.
We started off small, young guys. Didn't really know the game and like had to develop most of the guys. And this year, we got added a couple more pieces and we are more developed now and we know how to play the game, share the ball, work as a team.
And Coach Jordan mentioned the high educational standard at the school, comparing it to the high school version of Stanford University.
Academics are huge. They definitely stress how they want us to be 3-point honor roll students. That's probably the biggest piece. Education always comes first, student athlete. So I feel like education is the biggest piece in the program.
When you come to a school that you ain't got to worry about grades, you walk into the locker room, you're like, guys, what are you guys talking about? Are we talking about our chemistry class, coach? I'm like, well, I couldn't say nothing about that. So, like I said, a bunch of kids is really smart.
Last season, Golda Meir played all their home games on the campus of Milwaukee School of Engineering. But this season, the Owls had a little more home court advantage playing in the comfort of their own gym.
Confidence-wise and fans-wise, us having the fan support and stuff like that, it helped us out a lot.
And this year, they see who we got and see that we go out there and play hard every game, so they want to show up and support for us. The school culture is really, really great.
Because when you play here, it's like Duke. They're all on top of you. And great fan support. Everywhere we went this year, even on the road, we sold out.
And folks, don't make the mistake and think Golda Meir don't have ball players, because junior forward Brandon Robinson knows how to get buckets.
To Brandon Robinson, he's a monster, 6'3", one of the top 10 leading scorers in the city of Milwaukee, great rebounder. I think he got a very, very upside. I think he's like a 3 in college though.
It's a great feeling that I'm being recognized in such a way that I wasn't recognized in the past, but it feels great.
Congratulations, Golda Meir, for being Press Plus Team of the Week.
Yeah!
Hey, I'm J.R. Radcliffe from Lake Country Publications and Now Newspapers. The winter prep postseason is in full swing, and you can check out full coverage at lakecountrynow.com and mycommunitynow.com. We've got coverage from the state individual wrestling meet this past weekend, as well as boys and girls basketball ongoing coverage. You can find my story on the Waukesha South state champion swimming team at waukeshanow.com. And your home for all things Milwaukee area prep basketball is Roundball Rankings at mycommunitynow.com/roundball. Preps Plus, we'll be right back.
We get it. You're always on the go. That's why Boston Store is ready anytime you want to shop, day or night, or anytime in between. At bostonstore.com, you'll find more brands, styles, and sizes to get you going, to work or to play. And with web exclusives, free online shipping, and convenient in-store returns, it's never been easier. What are you waiting for? Shop bostonstore.com. Boston Store, your store, your style.
Think of joint pain like a warning light in your car. It means something in your body isn't working right or could be damaged. And the Freightart and the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network is where you go to keep everything in working order. Our orthopedic and spine specialists will show you all your options, from non-surgical remedies like physical therapy to minimally invasive treatments and advanced surgical techniques to get you going again. Isn't it good to know what is possible?
Like any great athletic program, managing concussion is a team effort. The concussion management team consists of the athletic trainers, the physicians, and the therapists working alongside the athlete and their team, the coaches, and their parents to ensure a complete recovery. While more than 80% of concussions resolve within 2 weeks, sometimes it takes more than relative rest or limiting activity to get the athlete back to full sport. Sometimes additional interventions are needed when concussion symptoms linger longer than expected. Recommended treatment may include vestibular therapy that focuses on balance and dizziness, or graded exercise treatment in which an athlete slowly integrates into full activity. When sidelined with a concussion, it is essential that the entire concussion management team work together to get the athlete back in the game as quickly and safely as possible.
To learn more about the sports medicine program, visit freightart.com/sports.
While boys basketball teams hope their season ends in Madison, the same can be said for hockey squads.
On Friday night, two of the Milwaukee area's top teams met with a state tournament berth on the line.
It's always nice to have home ice, especially when a trip to Madison and the state hockey tournament is on the line. And that's the case tonight. It's Arrowhead hosting University School in the Section 8 final. Last year in the sectionals, it was the Wildcats ending the Warhawks season. Arrowhead looking for some payback tonight. USM on the attack early. Andrew Malik splits the defense, but loses the puck as he goes airborne. Halfway through the first, Warhawk Jack Schlinsag is sandwiched by two Wildcats, but gets the puck to Connor Akers, who punches it by goalie Frank Fee. Arrowhead up 1-0 after one. Now mid-second, USM being outshot 17-3 at this point, but that didn't matter to Brandon McGill. He lifts this shot over the shoulder of Warhawk goalie Peter Genitempo as the game is even at one. But just 2 minutes later, Arrowhead with a quick response. Elijah Tormala with the drive. Schlinsog screens the goalie as the shot ends up in the back of the net. Warhawks back on top, 2-1 after two periods. To start the third, Arrowhead has fresh ice and is on the power play, and they take full advantage. Tormala with a rocket from long range. Jackson Carr finds the rebound and sneaks it past Fee for the two-goal cushion. Now 3-1 Hawks. Meanwhile, Genitempo was stellar in goal all night for Arrowhead. The Wildcats on the attack. The rebound is loose, but he grabs it just before it crosses the goal line. Time for the Warhawk offense to put this one on ice. Dylan Cox with a one-timer from the point. He beats Fee glove side for the clincher. Arrowhead gets revenge and heads to Madison for the first time since 2009 with a 4-1 victory.
It's kind of surreal. We've been waiting for this all year, and just to kind of finally get it to happen is really nice, and we're just really excited.
Well, we've never been here before, and only two teams in history have done it, so it's pretty special to be a part of a team that's going.
We go into it thinking we're going to get the job done. These guys are full of confidence right now, and we're going to go into state with the same mentality we went in the sectionals. We'll get to Madison next week, and we'll go work hard for that.
Well, that's it for us tonight. Thanks for joining us.
And be sure to tune in every Sunday night in March. Next week, we'll have action from the boys' basketball and girls' basketball playoffs and oh so much more. I'm Lance Allen.
And I'm Mark Stewart. See you next week on Preps Plus.
The Milwaukee Journal Sentinel's Preps Plus is brought to you by Boston Store. Your store, your style. By the Frederick and the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network, where sports medicine experts help athletes maximize their potential.